In this video, I will show you how to use NoodleTools. This service is free to you through the Glendale Community College libraries. First, we're going to set up an account. Then we will create a project. Then we will add sources to our project. We will add note cards to our sources. And finally, we will export our works cited or references list into Google Docs. From the library website, go into Library Databases on the left. You want to access NoodleTools through the library databases, not through the open web. Under General, All Subjects, you will click on NoodleTools. Enter your MEID and password when prompted. If you already have a NoodleTools account, you will sign in using your personal ID that you created for NoodleTools and your password. If you do not yet have an account, click Register. Enter your expected year of graduation or leave this field blank. Make up a personal ID. We suggest that you use the first part of your MEID because when you check availability, it is usually available. Make up a password you will remember and retype it. You might want to jot this password down. Put the last four digits of the phone number you most commonly use and your initials. This will help the librarians retrieve your account information if you cannot remember how to get into NoodleTools. Finally, enter your school, your Maricopa email. And when you're all done, click Register. This will bring you to your projects page. In my account, I have already created two projects. If you just created your account, you are probably looking at a blank page. To make a new project, you want to click on the green Add New Project button at the upper right. Name your project. For example, you might want to do English 101, Works Cited. Choose a citation style. For English, I would choose MLA most likely. And for citation level, I recommend you use the junior level. You can always change any of this information later. Then hit Submit, and now you have created a brand new project. If you double click on the project, it will bring you to this screen. You have a lot of options on the left. To create a source, this would be a source of information that you are using in your paper. Click on the Add New Source button in the upper right. First, NoodleTools needs to know where you found your information. If you used a library database, click Database. If you used an open website, click Website. Or if you have a book or resource in your hand that's unprinted, you will click on Print or In Hand. I've selected Library Database. Next, NoodleTools asks me, what is it? And your librarian can help you determine what type of resource you are trying to cite. For example, if you found a journal article in a library database, you would click Journal. And now NoodleTools generates a form for you to fill out. And if, depending on what information you enter for the type of resource you have, a different form is generated. Fill out as much of the information as you can. And again, your librarian can help you. Once I enter my information for my source and click Submit, it will show me on my NoodleTools source screen for this project what that resource looks like. We still need to export this into Word or Google Doc, but working in NoodleTools, this is what a resource looks like once you have created a citation. If you need to edit the source, click on the three buttons to the right, and you will see an option for edit. This brings you back to the screen that you filled out. So here's all of the information that I filled out. In this particular example, I have made an annotation for my source, and perhaps I want to add some more information. I simply type into the screen. And once I'm happy with my changes, I click Save. Additionally, I can add a note card from this screen. These are notes that will not show on your final works cited or references list. Under Note Cards, I can hit New. Now I can do things like I can copy and paste direct quotations from my article. I can then put that direct quotation into my own words. That's called paraphrasing. And I can list my original ideas about the content in this portion. And once I do that, I will save and close my note card. I'm going to show you an example of a note card I made. I can tell that I've made one note card. It is attached to this source. I can make as many note cards as I need for this particular source. To view my note cards, I go into Note Cards on the left. This is showing me the note cards just for this project. I have one untitled note card, and I click on it to view. Here's my direct quote. Here's my paraphrase of that direct quote, and here are my own original ideas. I can add to this, or I can see if I've made spelling mistakes and I want to fix those. I can change that and save and close. I'm also going to title my note card, and I'm just going to call this one Detective Stories of Poe and Le Fanu. You can title your note cards whatever you want. Save and close. So now you can see on my note card, it's no longer untitled. To return to sources, I click on the Sources tab. Now I'm going to add any of my resources that I plan to use for this paper that I'm turning in. And when I am all done, I am going to export into Word or into Google Doc. I added a few sources to my Works Cited, and I see that I have put one source twice. So before you export your Works Cited or references list, you want to make sure that you haven't made any mistakes. I'm going to go ahead and delete one of these repeated references. And again, I click the three dots to the right of the source, and in this case, I say, I want to delete. It's going to ask me if I'm sure, and I'm going to say yes. Now I have those three sources, and I can see what types I have. I have one journal article, one film, and one open website. And now I am going to export. I'm simply going to click on the print icon up here. And this time it can choose Word or Google Doc. I'm going to export to Google Docs. I'm going to tell it that I want to export all of my sources. And this will take a minute or two, but this should bring you to Google Docs. And look at that. It has put my Works Cited list into perfect alphabetical order. It's spaced properly on the screen. I see my annotations. I see everything exactly the way I want it to print out and turn in to my teacher. This one I haven't put an annotation, so I might want to add an annotation here. If you make any changes to Google Docs after you've exported, or if you add more sources to NoodleTools, those changes don't automatically go from one platform to another. So if you add something, you want to make sure that your NoodleTools project is also properly updated. I return to my sources screen in NoodleTools for this project. If I want to go back to my project list of all of my projects, I simply click on Back to My Projects. Now I can see the three projects that I have created. And if I'm working on a different project, I'm going to go into that project and I'm going to look at my sources. I have one for this example, MLA. If I want to add more, I add new sources here. So NoodleTools does quite a bit for you. I'm going to go back to my new projects or to my projects once again. Just make sure that you are in the proper project for the assignment that you are working on. And if you need help, a librarian is always available to help you. You can contact us in multiple ways. We have an Ask a Librarian chat service that is available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You will find that this pops up on the GCC Library website. You can also call a librarian during our open hours. The phone number on the screen will get you to the reference desk to a librarian who can help you. And this semester we are open, so you can come into the library at Main or North Campus and speak to a librarian in person. Good luck with NoodleTools, good luck with your assignments, and have a wonderful semester.